This is a pool boiling problem where we have 10 copper tubes that are 15 millimeters in diameter, and each one is 0.5 meters long. And they're used to boil saturated water at one atmosphere. And if the tubes are operated at 80% of the critical heat flux, what we want to know is what is the vapor production rate with these 10 tubes. In addition, we want to know is what is the surface, the corresponding surface temperature of the tubes. So the heat transfer rate is the surface flux times the surface area, which is the surface flux times the number of tubes times pi dl. And this is equal to m dot h sub fg. And we should realize that this is nucleate boiling because we are only at 80% of the critical heat flux. So what we're looking for is this vapor production rate, or m dot, which is our heat flux times the number of tubes times pi dl divided by h sub fg, or the heat of vaporization. So the first thing we're going to need to do is find this heat flux, which is, again, 0.8 times Q max. So let's do our properties for our saturated water. So our rho sub L is 957.9 kilograms per meter cubed. That's the density of the liquid. The heat capacity of the liquid is 4,217 joules per kilogram K. The viscosity of the liquid is 279 times 10 to the minus 6 newtons seconds per meter squared. The Prandtl number of the liquid is 1.76, and the heat of vaporization is 2257 kilojoules per kilogram. And we're actually going to change that to 2257 times 10 to the third joules per kilogram, since everything else is in joules. Finally, we have the surface tension, which is 58.9 times 10 to the minus third newtons per meter, and our density of the vapor, which is 0.5955 kilograms per meter cubed. So the equation for the critical heat flux is 0.149 H sub Fg rho of the vapor, the surface temperature, times gravity, times the difference in densities over the density of the vapor squared, and this is all raised to the 1/4. And when we calculate that out, we get 1.26 times 10 to the 6th watts per meter squared. So our Q, or our heat flux, is 1.008 times 10 to the 6th watts per meter squared. And when we put that number times 10 times pi dl and divide it by our heat of vaporization, our vapor production rate, or m dot, is 0.105 kilograms per second. In order to find the corresponding surface temperature of a tube, we're going to need to find our difference in excess temperature. And so we're going to use the Rosenau correlation, which equals C sub SF H sub FG Prandtl to the N divided by our heat capacity of the liquid. And this is multiplied by our surface heat flux divided by our liquid viscosity, H sub Fg, all raised to the 1/3. And this is multiplied by the surface tension divided by gravity and the difference in the densities. And this whole thing is raised to the 1/6. Now, the C sub SF and our N are dependent on the solid and liquid combination. And since this is copper and water, C sub SF is 0.0128, and our N is equal to 1. So when we calculate our delta TE, we come up with 19.2 degrees Celsius. Therefore, our surface temperature is Tsat plus delta TE, or 100 plus 19.2, or that's going to equal 119.2 degrees Celsius.